Hi everyone, it's very early in the workshop. I have a very important day ahead of me. No joking around today because I really need to fix this on my table. I have the height modules here. Today I'm gonna adjust the height so the marble divider functions properly. I'm stricken by the gravitas du jour. No jokes today. So just a little reminder, you see that these modules have different numbers on them. I opened up two of them to show you what these numbers mean. 10 and 22. So if we look inside 22, we see that the path inside 22 is longer than the path inside 10. In the 22 path, I can almost fit 6 marbles. And if we transfer them to the 10 path, I can almost fit, but not really 5. So when I insert these height modules into the marble path, I can very accurately adjust the height of the top marble. So I put 5 marbles in the 2 module and 5 marbles in the 12 module. And you can see how much lower this marble sits from this module. I've been very happy with this design. It's been doing wonders for the marble divider, but I have a little bit of a worry coming up today. Up here is the marble divider. You see the top marble is flush and then all the other marbles are here. They go into the height module all the way down to the gate and the dropper. But I wonder if I have made the marble lanes a little bit too wide. So the marbles can kind of go to the sides into the walls like this. And I wonder in some curves if the marbles can like end up in different configurations. So perhaps this distance from here to here shifts a little bit. And perhaps that prevents us from getting a consistent flushness of the top marble. The goal with today is that this marble will pass over all these channels. As you can see now, it's getting stuck already on 13 there. If we get all this flush, it will roll straight over. And the way I'm going to do that is that I'm going to measure two things. I'm going to measure the measurement itself, how much off this marble is, and the consistency. Before the first measurement, I want to prime the channels. I'm playing one stroke each and I'm filling one marble. Two millimeters, minus two, plus three. So now I got all six measurements. I'm going to redo it so I can compare if this is consistent. Minus two on the first one, which I'm happy to see because that was the same we had before. This was plus three, plus 2.5, close. Okay, so I measured three times, that's enough for now, and pretty good results. It's very consistent actually, within like half a millimeter or 1 millimeter in some cases. This should mean that my design actually works, but we're not there yet. I kind of like when the marble sticks up a little bit. So this marble right here, it sticks up a little bit and the marble roll over that one very easily. So I don't think we should go for zero. So the target height will be 1 millimeter above the surface. So with these measurements, we now need to know what value the height modules had in this test. So I need to empty all the channels and get them out. Okay, this is a 13B module. So 13B has the value 0. I put 0 in here. 14B, 18. So now the idea is to make an educated guess of what new module we should try to put in for the second measurement test. I'm curious for this one because maybe we can replace the 6 with a 0. 1150. That does not work. Let's try this one. We want the marble to be 4 millimeter higher when we swap, maybe with 16. Actually, this is pretty close. So we're gonna put 16 into this slot for the next test. After some messing around, I have an idea of the new module values here, and it's a quite strange result where all the modules want to be like around 17. But this result is kind of fun because then I can make a lot of modules around these numbers with quite small differences so we can do very accurate adjustments. I'm going to try to speed CAD the new modules and then cut them on the CNC machine as fast as I can. Okay, so here is the height modules in CAD. Fusion 360 has a kind of new feature that I'm going to try for the first time today. So before, when I made these, I copied the parts. So I put them flat for the CNC machine. So for this top frame, I've also put them flat over here for making them on the CNC machine. There's a new function that should prevent me from having to do this. It's called manufacturing model. I never tried it. If it works the way I hope, it could be a gift from heaven. I'm going over to the manufacture workspace, and here under setup, we have the new option, newish option of create manufacturing model. So now in the tree, we have our original model, but we also have a new manufacturing module. The software should be able to put all the pieces flat for me with arrange. So now I'm going to select all these pieces. Ooh, this is magical if this works. Haha, yes. So I'm going to make some stupid changes to illustrate. I'm going to go over to design. So here we're seeing the same parts, but in the design. And I'm going to do something stupid. I'm just going to extrude this wall. So I'm making one piece smaller like that. Let's head over to manufacture. Yes, look at this. There it is. For 1 millisecond there, I wasn't wondering what the meaning of life is. I think another main feature is that you can make a sketch like this of your stock. Say, I know I have a plywood, piece of plywood that is like, okay, 40 centimeters times 60 centimeters, but I already used some parts of the plywood. So, you know, I can just go down in my workspace and I can just measure and see that. Okay, I only used up these circles. Look at that. It's just updating. Look at that, everyone. Okay. It just took my sketch and avoided the holes that I already used in the plywood. So now I should be able to move these circles. Yeah, look at that. And it just rearranged the pieces. Well done. So let's actually go and take some real world measurements and show how this actually works. So here's my outdoor material storage. And this is the plywood I want to use. And look at this. We have a perfect little square here. So I'm going to say 38 wide.
To 380 millimeter. It just changed automatically already. Here's the wonders of parametric CADing. This is the 18 value module. And the cool thing is that if we zoom in, you see it says 18 right here. If I done it correctly, I can just add another value. You can see the marble lane. If I now hit 6, look at that. I have now a parametric marble lane. I can do all our different values, 16.5. So you can see how organic this model is. And then of course, the coolest thing is that all this will update in our manufacturing model automatically. Num, 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 num. Let's start with 16. They're gonna be so similar, so I'm not going to be sure which one is which one. So I'm thinking we should actually etch the value into the modules with the CNC machine. I wanna make a lot of variations on this component. So what I'm doing is I'm copying, but then I'm pasting new. So paste new in the menu, and I want to move this 42 millimeters because that's the distance, so 42. And the reason I'm pasting a new is because this is a completely new design, but with all the parametric functions built in. So I'm gonna rename that to 62. And I should only have to change two parameters to create a completely new version here. 16.2, it updated perfectly. 62, boom, and that's it. So that's a really nice way to do multiple copies that are almost similar and save all the work possible and just giving the only input needed to create the difference, right? No jokes. I need to make 12 more unique parts, and I'm gonna start a timer to see how long time that takes now. Go. Okay, 7.5 minutes. That could have gone faster. Have you ever seen anything more beautiful? We can start with engraving the numbers. I'm gonna engrave the numbers with a 2mm tool. Where's all my tools? I didn't put them back. No joking today. So if you see those red lines there, you can already see that the tool is going to make a ramp down. So it's gonna plunge in a zigzag pattern down and ramping it way down. We do not have the time for that ramp. This decides how the tool is going down. So for example, say this was metal, you don't want to plunge straight down and cut from the bottom of the tool bit. You want to come from the side and ease your way into the material. This is plywood, so we're going to choose plunge. Unsupported geometry for 2D open pocket detection. Marble hobby project gone wrong. That's going to be the title for today's video. We got our numbers, so let's cut the marble lanes themselves. And so now in this cut, you still see the individual tool because we have a too high step over. Step over means the distance between the parallel tool paths. The smaller step over distance, the finer result and the longer time. That's the compromise we have to do. But 3mm is a huge step over. I'm thinking 1mm is going to be a good step over, which means the tools will move 1mm to the side and then cut again. So perhaps not all of you find this information absolutely crucial for the continuation of your life. What I like with Wintergatan 2 is that I feel the freedom to kind of show you what this process is like. Even if you don't have a CNC machine, you now have a grasp, and programming robots is basically what we all are going to work with within the next 2 years. Universal basic income is a fantastic idea. In Gothenburg, I went to a lecture with an economics professor about universal basic income. I'm a huge fan. If I choose one hole, I can choose select same diameter. So finally, we don't have to click 200 million times.
This looks too small. This doesn't look right.
So something looked wrong with the marble bath. It looked too small. So when we see here in the simulation, we see that there's uncut stock there. So even though I spent a lot of time on this, I actually made a mistake, but I can fix it easy. I'm going to add a toolpath the other direction, like this. Did you see how much wider the marble path became? So I'm just gonna switch between the toolpath directions. Narrow, wide.
Thank you.
Okay, we have our height modules. I'm curious. I'm going to just test some of them. 7.6, 7.4, 7.2. There's 5 marbles in each of these, and as you see much more of the back wall here, and then a little bit less, little less, little less, little less, and least here. This is a very nice granularity of the selection of these height modules. Awesome. This day just flew past me. I was really sure I could cut these, assemble them, and make measurement number 2. I have to do that tomorrow. I got a little stuck in the manufacturing model in Fusion 360. So the manufacturing model was super fun. I had an issue where things started to move around when I didn't want them to move around. So I have to figure that out. But I learned a lot today, so that's a good thing. It's, you know, it's James Clear. Don't focus at the results. Focus at your systems instead. Awesome to have you with me in the workshop every day. Tomorrow we're gonna measure the new one and see if we can nail the top height of the marble in the marble divider. That's everything my life is about right now. That's it, see you tomorrow.